Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm making rasmalai cake. Let's start making this cake, but before that, if you are new here, welcome. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please take a moment and do subscribe. In a bowl, take 1/2 cup of oil, 1/2 cup of sweetened condensed milk, 1/2 cup of room temperature milk. Give it a quick mix and combine all the wet ingredients together. Now I'm sifting dry ingredients. I'm taking 1 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, and 1/4 teaspoon of cardamom powder. Sift all the dry ingredients. Now mix all the ingredients well and make a smooth batter. This should be the consistency of the batter. Now I'm pouring this batter in a greased 7-inch cake mold. Pat it a few times and bake it in a preheated oven for 30 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius. While the cake is in the oven, let's prepare the rasmalai. Starting off with 1 liter of full fat milk. Keep stirring the milk and let it come to the boil. Now I'm diluting 2 tablespoons of vinegar into 1/2 cup of room temperature milk. You can do the same with lemon juice, but make sure you dilute it first and then mix it. When milk reaches to the boil, turn off the flame and let it rest for exact 2 minutes. After 2 minutes, add the vinegar mixture gradually. Now stir it slowly and let the milk curdle. Milk has curdled now. I'm going to strain it in a bowl using a muslin cloth or any cotton cloth. Wash your chhena with some cold water. The reason behind washing it with cold water, one is we are removing the smell and the sour taste of vinegar, which is very important for rasmalai. And second reason is, when we add cold water, it will instantly give the chhena texture. Now strain all the extra water by gently squeezing it. Now you have to hang this cloth for 30 minutes, so all the extra water will drain out naturally. After 30 minutes, take the chhena in a large plate. Now knead the chhena for about a minute and add 1 teaspoon of corn flour. If you don't have corn flour, you can also add 1 teaspoon of all-purpose flour or maida. Knead the chhena for 15 minutes or until it becomes crack-free. You can see by making a ball. If the ball looks crack-free, that means chhena is ready. Do the same with the remaining chhena. I'm making 10 equal balls. Now keep these balls aside and let's prepare the sugar syrup. Take 1 1/2 cup of sugar and add 5 cups of water in a heavy bottom saucepan. Let the syrup come to the boil. Add all the balls one by one and make sure the sugar syrup is boiling. Once you add the balls, close the pan with the lid and let it cook for 15 minutes at high flame. After 15 minutes, flip each ball and again close it with the lid and cook for another 10 minutes. Now after 10 minutes, turn off the flame and transfer each ball in chilled ice water. Let's prepare the rasmalai. I'm taking 1 liter of full fat milk in a heavy bottom saucepan. Keep stirring the milk so it doesn't stick at the bottom of the pan. I'm also adding about 1/4 teaspoon of saffron. I'm not adding any food color. If you want, you can add. I'm also adding 1/4 teaspoon of cardamom powder, some chopped almonds and pistachios. I'm also adding 1/4 cup of sugar. You can change the sugar quantity according to your taste. Let the milk boil for about 15 minutes. Now turn off the flame and let it come to the room temperature. After 2 to 3 hours, I'm going to squeeze each ball and add it into the milk syrup. Now let this rasmalai rest for 1/2 hour. Our cake has also baked perfectly. Unmold the cake and let it cool down completely. Meanwhile, let's prepare the frosting. Take 1 cup of cold heavy whipping cream. In that, add 1/4 cup of powdered sugar. Instead of powdered sugar, you can also use icing sugar. Now whisk this cream until stiff peaks. Cream has whipped perfectly. Now let's decorate the cake. My cake has also cooled down completely. I'm slicing my cake into half. I'm placing my first part of the cake on the cake turntable, applying some rasmalai syrup. Since we are making rasmalai cake, so instead of sugar syrup, I'm using rasmalai syrup. Applying some whipping cream. And some rasmalai chunks. Chunk size is completely a personal choice, but I like it to be small. That's why I have cut my rasmalai into 4 equal parts. Now I'm placing my other part of the cake over the rasmalai and I'm repeating the process by applying some rasmalai syrup and some whipping cream. Now I'm crumb coating my cake. In the remaining cream, I have added some yellow food color. Yellow color is completely optional. Apply some yellow cream on the sides. Now making this design by using a spatula. Using a rasmalai chunk, I'm making the center of the flower, and using a nozzle, I'm making the leaves of the flower. You can create any design of your choice. Garnishing it with some saffron and chopped pistachios. If you have dry rose petals, use that also. Rasmalai cake is ready to enjoy now. If you like this video, do share it with your family and friends and hit the bell icon so you get the notification whenever I upload a new video. Thank you for watching. See you next time.